From the high desert and the great American Southwest, I bid you all good evening, good afternoon, good morning. Whatever the case is, wherever you are, doesn't matter. Welcome to Open Lines tonight. We're going to have some fun. The rules of this program are no bad language. Language. Well, both of them, above all, really. I want to take a moment because it's very, very important. If you have a smartphone, that's right, if you have a smartphone, it doesn't matter what kind, you know, Apple, Android, I'm not so sure about BlackBerry, but I think they probably work. Somebody should call with the BlackBerry so I find out. It's so easy to call us and sound like $1 million. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, if you use Skype on a smartphone, oh my goodness, you really, really, really sound good. You sound like you're right here in the studio. And so what you say carries more authority, when you say it. So, here's how you do it. You put Skype in your smartphone. You just go to the store and get Skype. And then once you get it, it is this simple. You go to add contact, not to where you dial a number, but to add a contact. There's a little plus sign in Skype. And you add me. And how do you do that? You, if you're in North America, America, or Canada, you add me by putting in MITD51. That's Midnight in the Desert, MITD, it's not case sensitive, 51. And then I'll be in your contact list, and you can press that and dial me, free. Now, worldwide, it works the same way. The difference is, if you're outside of North America, you put in MITD55. Again, you go to add a contact, that's a little plus sign in Skype, and put in MITD55. Then I'll be in your contact list. You can press it, and away we go. All right, before we get started, this is going to be a crazy, crazy show tonight. This is very serious news, I think. North Korea says it is all set for an all-out war against South Korea beginning at 5:30 p.m. That'd be 2:30 here in the morning on the West Coast. This is a deadline that this idiot in North Korea has set for the South Koreans to stop broadcasting propaganda. They've got all these speakers set up, broadcasting all the propaganda into North Korea. North Korea is saying if they don't stop, if they don't dismantle the speakers by that time, it is war. I mean, war. There's already been artillery exchange, that kind of thing. I think the North Koreans aimed at the speakers and missed. Doesn't say much for their smart weapons, huh? Anyway, they missed, and then South Korea fired a whole artillery barrage back at them. And now there is this deadline. And, you know, this maniac in North Korea, you cannot tell if he's serious, but giving a time deadline sounds serious. The U.S. actually suspended the exercises it was doing for a period of time with South Korea because they consider it that serious. So, you know, it could be the same old baloney from North Korea, or it could be a war just after I get off the air. Hard to say. The U.S. stock market took a really, really big hit. I think it went about 530-some-odd points down. It's bad. Everybody is worried about China. China is driving all of this. Now, oil prices, on the other hand, are going down to about 40 bucks a barrel. So that's the good news. They expect the at-the-pump prices to roughly become 2 bucks. That sounds good, right? I don't know about the rest of it, though. The Vatican's chief astronomer Says he does not believe that we will encounter any intelligent forms of life from outside our own galaxy anytime soon, especially, said he, when it's so difficult to encounter intelligent life here on our planet. sense of humor in the Vatican. The father said that, or made an admission, actually, that the Bible is not a scientific book. This is Father Funes, or Funes, F-U-N-E-S, Funes, I guess, Funes, I don't know. Anyway, he says, if we look for scientific responses to our questions in the Bible, we are making a mistake. Now, when do you hear that from the Vatican? My goodness. All right, and here's the big one. This is going to drive a special line tonight. Now, we do have open lines. That means... yeah, you know, call about anything. I don't care. It doesn't matter. Anything that that you want to talk about is fair game. But the Vatican now says that demon possession is at, quoting here, emergency levels. A top Vatican meeting, demon busters and psychiatrists group warned that more and more people were dabbling in black magic, becoming possessed as a result. Walter Cascali, the spokesman for the International Association of Exorcists, which is now holding its first meeting ever at the Holy See, said last night, the practice of the occult, Satanism, and abnormal things is opening the gateway to an extraordinary amount of demonic activity. They have never, ever seen anything like it. They are saying it is at emergency levels. And this will drive my special line tonight. Other than open lines and anything you want to talk about, what I want to know is the following. Have you made a deal with the devil? I really mean that. Have you made a deal with the devil? And I know a lot of you have. Now, I know it's going to be hard to pick up the phone and admit it, but I think many of you will. And if you have made a deal with the devil, how's it going? Now listen to me. Contrary to what you may see in the movies, there is not going to be some guy with horns, glowing red eyes, coming to see you, you know, with a piece of paper to sign. Doesn't work that way. You can make a deal with the devil by doing it in your head. You can say, I want $1 million, and I am willing to, this is just rehearsing, so if you're out there, devil, don't take this seriously, I've got my million. I'm willing to sacrifice everything, anything, whatever, to get there. And once you have done that mentally, you have made a deal with the devil. You have. Believe it. Doesn't have to be a signed document. This is something you do in your own mind and your own soul. And I think that it is irrevocable. I think you cannot, once you've made this deal, revoke the deal. It's interesting, I had this topic up on Facebook, and I got a response before I even went on the air from Gary, who is writing from the Czech Republic. And he said, yes, I made a deal with the devil, and every spirit of earth and sky for the woman of my dreams. That was 5 years ago, Gary says, and we are more in love than ever. But it has cost me everything. Tough one. He may call in tonight. I hope he does, because that's exactly what I'm talking about. This is a pact you make in your own mind. And again, I don't know this for sure, but I'm pretty sure it's irrevocable. Once you've made it, you may get what you wanted, but I don't think you can take the deal back. All right, so here's a quick rendition of the numbers, and then away we go. Are you ready? My public number, the one all of you can use, is area code 952 225 952-225-5278. Again, area code 952-225-5278. Put a 1 in front of that, of course. Now, if you have made a deal with the devil, I'm going to give out a number right now, and that is area code 575-208-7787. Got that? Devil doers, have you got that? Area code 575-208-7787. With all...
Take a walk on the wild side of midnight. From the Kingdom of Nye, this is Midnight in the Desert with Art Bell. Please call the show at 1-952-225-5278. That's 1-952-CALL-ART.
This is going to be a wild one, no question about it. Once again, those who have made a deal with the devil, and I'm not going to identify where you're calling from, by the way, should call at area code 575-208-7787. Every line is full. That line actually was full, the devil line, 575-208-7787, but he chickened out. I know, it's hard. It's really hard. Well, there, it's ringing again. So let's give it a try. Let's see what we get. You are on the air. Hello.
Hello. I was actually just wanting to make a comment about something that you had said.
Wait a minute. You're calling the I made a deal with the devil line.
Oh, okay. I can't say it here then.
No, you can't. Not unless you made it. Did you? You sound like you might have made a deal. Did you?
No. I
oh, come on now. Come on. You dialed the number. You must have made a deal. Think back. Think back in your life now. There was never a time when you said, oh, God, no matter who it is, I don't care. I'll make a deal if I get so-and-so.
No.
All right, then I have to ban you from this line.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. It was a pleasure. Let's go to Shane on Skype. Hello, Shane.
Hey, Art, thanks for taking my call.
You bet.
I'm amazed, first of all, how clear it sounds when I'm on hold, even on the Skype thing.
Well, yeah, I know. It's astounding, actually, audio. Where are you?
I am in Colby, Kansas.
And what are you talking to me on?
I'm talking to you on an iPhone.
Now, see? Case in point, folks.
And I don't even have the iPhone 6 like you've got. I got the iPhone 5S.
Well, they make good products, sir.
Yes, they do.
Even if their stock took a giant hit today, by the way. So did
Yeah, well. I saw that, but yeah. They still make good stuff. I wanted to talk to you briefly. One of the most fascinating subjects I've come across in my life is Area 51. I can't read enough about it, and I heard you talking a couple of weeks ago on the show about a caller that you had years ago who flew an airplane in there, and I found it on YouTube, and I listened to that.
That's right.
I got to say, I think it's real.
Oh, me too.
I listened to that thing over and over, and I really think the guy did it. Now, my question is, did you ever hear anything about that guy?
No, and I don't like losing listeners that way either. I really don't. I mean, I think he probably went down in flames, more or less.
Well, yeah, because the government wouldn't say that somebody flew a plane into Area 51.
Look here, I live right next to Area 51. I can tell you the signs are very clear. Deadly force is authorized, and they're not kidding. They will use it.
Mm-hmm. One more quick thing. Well, actually, two quick things. One, are you ever going to do a show on Area 51?
I'm sure there's no question about it. I will, yes, of course.
And then my final question, and
yes.
Then I'll let you go, is how close have you actually gotten to Area 51? Like, have you gotten to the mailbox that you see on TV where you can go?
Yes, I have
and
been
And what
there.
Did you see when you went there?
The mailbox.
But you, I mean, what did you see when you looked out past that?
Well, when you're in Nevada, you see a lot. I mean, okay. your line of sight is probably 50 miles to the mountains, you know. So, no saucers, nothing like that. Saw the mailbox, thought about going further and didn't. You know, that sign is really effective, when it says they will use deadly force, they will. And so, you know, You do it and let me know how it goes.
I'm not going to do that.
Uh-huh. Have a good night, sir.
Yeah, you too.
See you later. All right, on May, this is my I Made a Deal with the Devil line. Hello.
Hello.
Hi. So, do I have the real thing here? Have you actually at some point made a deal with the devil?
Well, I went through a process that I thought was going to do that. I can't tell you with any certainty what degree of success came around from that, but I certainly went through a process, and some very scary things happened as a result of that. So,
well, okay. Why did you, well, most importantly, why did you decide to make the deal?
I don't know. I guess I was very young at the time, and I felt powerless.
Mm-hmm.
And I felt like maybe this would be an opportunity for me to get out of economic oppression and several other things that I saw as my future at that time. I had medical conditions and mm-hmm. and poverty and
now
things
I
wanted to escape.
I get it. So, what was your wish at the time? You wanted economic prosperity. You wanted money.
Well, in actuality, I had already done a couple of candle magic things that I had learned by purchasing books at a New Age bookstore for money, and that had kind of worked, and a girl, and that had kind of worked. I'd seen some results from doing those repetitive meditative things around that.
Right.
So the actual request that I had at that time was, I know this is silly, but the ability to levitate another human.
To levitate, not yourself, but another.
Correct. If someone were attacking me, or if I wanted to, I don't know, coerce someone into doing something, that if I could just levitate them off of the ground a little bit or something of that nature to scare them, that would be sufficient to,
make the
reach
deal.
Other goals in life.
All right. So are you able to levitate anybody?
No, not in any real way. I was a professional magician for a while, so I don't know to what degree that trickery works.
Well, it sounds to me like you, it sounds to me like you kind of signed the deal when you did the candle stuff and the rituals and the money and the girl. That probably sealed the deal anyway.
Well, what was very strange for me was I had purchased a prop skull made of plastic from a Halloween store or whatever,
yes.
And I had a large black candle that I placed in the top of it, and I went through this process. I used a communion wafer, but it wasn't a communion wafer that had been blessed or anything. It was just something I purchased at a Christian bookstore, and I had prepared that and written a request on a piece of paper and burned it over that candle, whatever.
We're talking serious ritual here.
Yeah, I just made it up. I didn't have a book that told me to do that. I just did it.
You got the money. You got the girl.
And but during that particular ritual, the candle melted very quickly. Went down into the skull, which was made of plastic, and that melted very quickly.
Further evidence, sir, the deal was consummated.
Yeah, and I was awakened by my parents. The room was filled with black smoke from the... from the melting plastic.
You have it,
boy. At some point, I passed out.
I understand.
So,
sounds serious.
Yeah, that was my experience.
So when you get down to the big fire, well, how old are you now?
I'm 41 now. I was 41. Probably around 17 at that time.
I see. So let's see, another 30 or 40 years easily as yours, maybe even 50. And then...
I have kidney disease now, about 19% kidney function, so
okay.
I'm approaching end of
another,
life.
Another 10, maybe 20 years, and then, listen, I wish there was a way you could, when you meet your, what would be the right word? Normally you would say maker, but, I guess your business partner. All right. Well, thanks for the call. I appreciate it. Very honest and very straightforward. There you have it. He cut his deal. I told you there'd be people. I told you. So the deal line, if you made a deal with the devil, it's area code 575-208-7787. Let's go here on the phone and say hello there. Hello?
Hey, Art.
Yes,
Michael,
hey.
From Lake Charles.
Lake Charles, Louisiana.
Yes, sir. How are you?
I'm just fine.
I've been on hold, so I haven't been able to be hearing the show. I've had my radio off. But
well, you should be able to hear it on hold.
No, it was just there was nothing on hold.
Really?
Yeah, nothing.
No, wait a minute. I'm going to put you on hold, and I'm going to count to four, and you tell me if you hear me, okay? One, two, three, four. Did you hear that?
Nothing.
I beg pardon?
Nothing.
You did or didn't?
I did not hear anything. It's just silence.
Oh, man, that's not cool. That's not cool. You're supposed to be getting program audio when you're on hold.
Sure was. There's none at all.
Okay, that's thank you for informing me.
Yeah,
I'll ask the next caller as well. What can I do for you?
Hey, I just wanted to first of all welcome back, and I wanted to thank your family for allowing you to come back, because I'm sure that's a sacrifice on all your parts. Just
well, you're right. It is, and I want to thank my family for it, too. They miss me, and, doing a radio program takes more than you think it does. People think, you know, 3 hours, come on, anybody can do that. No, it takes preparation. It takes a lot.
Well, we thank them because we get to reap the benefits of having you.
Well, thank you.
Yes, sir. I wanted to tell you about an experience that happened years ago. We saw a craft per se in my parents' backyard. This was probably 20 years ago. In the middle of the night, my sister had gotten up from her room and went through their living room, going to the kitchen, and they had a huge plate glass window, and she sees this disc shape about 2 foot in diameter, circular.
Yeah.
That seems to be floating. I don't know how much time you have.
Well, not a lot. I mean, you've got to get to it. So, okay, a disc, as in flying saucer.
Seemingly.
Yes, okay.
Seeming to be floating and hovering, going up and down a little bit. It's got a green light, and it's foggy. It's a foggy night, and the green is just illuminating the ground. And occasionally, it has a red flash of light on it. So we watched it for quite some time. My parents got up. They watched. Tried to take pictures. We looked at it. My grandfather, who lived about 15 minutes away, my dad called and said, "You've got to come see this." We drove over, and then we turned into, "What do you do? Now we're seeing this. What do we do with this?" My grandfather had some friends that worked at the sheriff's department, and he decided that we needed to call the law. So they came out and got out there with the bullhorn and talked to it.
And said, so they're yelling up at a flying saucer? With
please
a bullhorn?
Please state your business.
wait a minute. Okay, stop. You're telling me the cops came out with a bullhorn. They're yelling at the saucer to please state your business, or what?
They just wanted to know what's going on.
Yeah.
Got lights on it. And let me fast forward because I know you're short on time all the way to the end.
Did they draw their guns?
No guns were drawn, but by the end, Wildlife and Fisheries was dispatched to remove their mosquito trap that they had placed on my parents' property without permission.
You're telling me that's what it was?
That's what it turned out to be.
Oh, good Lord.
But everybody was up all night long, and it was a fun night.
I'm sure it was. All right, thank you very much for the call. And the story that I thought went somewhere, and can you imagine? Come down now or we're going to shoot. On my I Made a Deal with the Devil line, you're on the air. Hello.
Hey, Art.
Hey.
It's Lewis from...
Well, you don't have to say where you're from, Lewis. You did make a deal with the devil, right?
I did make a deal with the devil when I was younger, when I was around 21. I'm kind of embarrassed, but
that's all right.
I wanted a lot of sex with women.
How's it gone?
It went very well. I had sex.
Lots and lots
women.
Of it. Really?
Lots of it.
You made this deal at what age now?
I was 21 years old, Art.
21.
I'm embarrassed to say.
No, no, no. It's all right. I understand. Sex is a very strong, I guess compulsion would be the right word. And so you basically said, look, you give me all the women or whatever women I want, and I will give you my soul.
And I ended up going to the seedy gothic club out in Los Angeles, Hollywood, California, and I met this really hot chick.
Mm-hmm.
She claimed to be a vampire. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, who doesn't want to take a vampire home, right? And when she was at my place...
Now, remember, you got to keep your language clear here.
Yes, sir, of course. She took me... I took her home, and she pulled out a vial of blood, and she wanted me to drink some with her. So, that's what I thought. And I said, I'd rather drink your blood. And she obliged, and she cut her wrist a little bit, and she let me suck from her wrist. And then she wanted to suck from mine. And I'd never done that before. I was young and didn't really know what to do. But I ended up going through with it. And, you know, just as a... things kept going.
How old are you now?
I'm 38.
38.
I'm old. Yes, I'm old now.
Still getting women? Are you still getting women?
I mean, surprisingly, yes. They just keep throwing themselves at me. It never stops.
I get it.
I mean, it's
sounds good.
So I mean, for me, the pact with the devil was the best thing I ever did in my life.
I wonder, how many women, I mean, I'm after only a ballpark figure here, but how many women since you made the pact do you think you've had? Just a guess.
I know it's been over 100.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, it's been over 100, and, you know, the only thing that ever went wrong was just a quick bout of chlamydia, but that got taken care of real quick.
Listen to me. A quick bout of chlamydia is going to be nothing compared to what you're headed for, you know?
Oh, yeah, well.
It's not so quick, trust me. Quick bout of chlamydia. Yeah, right. So this is going to be our night, huh? People who have made a deal with the devil. Area code 575-208-7787. Listen, let's go make that look like a walk in the park. Hello there on Skype, James, I believe it is.
I don't even know how to follow that up.
I don't know how to follow it either. Back away from your mic a little. You're too loud.
No problem.
There you go.
Well, Art, it's really good to have you back on.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
I grew up listening to you late night at 36 now, and I've been listening to you ever since I heard you first on the radio back in my teens.
Uh-huh. You know what's going to happen to that guy who was just on? He's going to get down there, and they're all going to be down there waiting for him, and every single one of them is going to be diseased.
It's absolutely hysterical. It's a great line for tonight, I think.
It is. And listen, my devil line is ringing off the hook, so.
Yeah, no kidding.
Yeah.
One quick question. The audio, I have to say, you and Keith have done a fantastic job.
Thank you.
It's better than anybody else is doing, be it radio or online, and it just sounds great.
On
so
Keith,
my question
behalf,
along those lines
I
is, what type of headset are you using?
It is a German headset. I really shouldn't go beyond that, but I use a headset mic. You know, that way I can move around in here, and I'm always the same distance from the mic, so it doesn't sound weird when I move around.
Well, it sounds great. Again, we're just glad to have you back on the air.
All right. Well, thank you.
I do have one quick thing, though.
Yes, yes.
I did a little road project out there close to close to the Roswell incident.
Oh.
Roswell's closer to the incident was actually closer to a city called Corona
That's
than
right.
it is to actually Roswell.
Did you bring back any souvenirs?
You know, I went out there, and it has got to be about the calmest place I've ever been. It's, you know, it's there's nobody for miles around. The wind blows, and that's about it. And it's a very calm, soothing, relaxing place where you can see the stars.
No, even the birds don't chirp.
No, actually, you don't hear birds. You don't hear birds.
That's because it's really completely dead, sir. It's a dead zone.
That is a little true.
Damn, dead zones at sea, and down there, I'm sure they've got one on land.
That's true.
All right, brother.
Appreciate your time, and that you're back on radio. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much. And, well, whoever it was couldn't hold. We had yet another I Made a Deal with the Devil caller. And these are serious, you know, really serious. As I mentioned at the beginning of the program, it doesn't mean that you have to meet with a horned one. It doesn't mean that you have to actually sign a paper. It doesn't work that way at all. In fact, it's much more of a subtle thing, as you've been hearing from these callers. In your own mind, you can do it. You can say, look, I want this. I want all these women. I want all this money, whatever it is you're going to make the deal for. And you can seal that deal in your own mind. And trust me when I say it is irrevocable. So, if you made a deal for women, you might as well, you know, go all out, as it were. I don't know about that last caller. Too many TV shows. Hello there, you're on the air.
Hey, hi, this is Tom from Florida, and it's Manny Roswell's, and it's a great honor to speak with you.
Thank you.
Yeah, I just wanted to bring up... First, I wanted to state a comment and then give you an experience I had.
Okay.
The comment I have is, it goes back to your question of, like, if there are time travelers in the future, where are the time travelers?
It's a good one.
Well, I've heard the theory about all these UFOs that have been popping up around the world. I strongly believe that it's a very good possibility that could very well be us in the future, visiting the past in certain times, and even experiences people have with these gray aliens, and they also experience humanoids with the gray aliens. It's very possible that the grays could be a form of biological robots that are like the assistants.
What I think. Right now, we're going through a period of intermarriage in America, in the world. I mean, you see people married to, my wife is Filipino. You see people married to Mexicans, to people from South America, Europeans married to Asians. We're getting this great mix that's going on, and it's accelerating. It's going faster and faster and faster. And I think that eventually we'll all be grays.
Yeah, and there could be I'm just going back to the whole, like, people experiencing also humanoids.
I think we'll all be grays, sir, with somewhat Asian eyes. Think about it.
Yeah.
I mean, if we continue intermarrying the way we're doing, we will be grays with somewhat Asian eyes, and I'll leave that thought with you.
Yeah, and the atmosphere of the Earth could change by then. Yeah, I mean, that's evolution.
That's evolution, is right.
Yeah. The experience I had was in a house I lived in when I was a teenager up in New York. I believe it possibly had paranormal activity in it. The reason why I say that is I remember one morning I was sleeping in my bed, and my dad he'd be getting up to go to work and everything. Normally he'd come in before he'd leave to say goodbye to me. Well, I was laying there, and I heard him going in from out of his room to the kitchen and all that.
Right.
And the door, like, I had my eyes closed, but it seemed like the door to my room opened, because I, you know how you can sometimes see the, even with your eyes closed, you can see the room brighten up a little bit?
Sure, sure.
But, yeah, I got that sensation, and I looked over at the door, and I saw a shadowy figure of a man who I thought was my dad, but yeah. I didn't really see features of him, and it approached my bed, and here I was waiting for my dad to lean over and, you know, say something to me, and it was just like it was never there to begin with.
Shadow person.
And what's weird about that is I remember we went away for the summer, 1 year, and we had our neighbors watching over the house.
Did you go under the covers?
No,
What kind of kid are you? If you got a shadow person in front of you or an unknown being, you always go under the covers. Everybody knows that.
I thought it was my dad. I wasn't scared. Yeah. I expected it to be my dad, but yes. It wasn't. It was like it wasn't there to begin with. Anyway, we went away for the summer, and when we got back, the neighbors, they wanted to tell us something, and their little daughter, I remember her pointing up, just, you know, her parents said, tell them what you saw. And she pointed up at my bedroom window. It happened to be my window of our house. And said, I saw an angel looking out at me.
An angel, huh?
And then if you think about it, what would a little, how would a little kid, you know, experience something like, describe something like that? You know what I mean? It just gave me chills. And there were other little things that happened. It wasn't.
Well, that one's not so bad. An angel is good. Unlike when I go to this line and I meet somebody who has made a deal with the devil. Turn your device down, devil dealer. Come on, turn it down.
I'm really sorry about that, Mr. Bell. I'm in the car. I'm actually driving.
Okay.
From work.
You know you're not supposed to be talking and driving, right?
It's an absolute honor to talk to you, Mr. Bell.
Thank you.
And a couple of days ago, you had...
Wait a minute. Hold on. I'm not going to let you go on. You got to listen to me. Have you made a deal with the devil? No. I'm leaving the line. If they won't pause to talk. See, he was trying to get a story in, but it obviously wasn't the deal that I'm looking for. On Skype, I've got Matt. Hello, Matt.
Oh, Art Uber Roswell's from New Orleans.
Thank you. How's New Orleans, by the way?
I wanted to tell you about 10 years ago this week, I was listening to you as Hurricane Katrina approached. I believe you were talking to a friend of yours that worked at a Lake Charles station.
Right.
That you hunted tornadoes with.
Yeah, that would be just Lynn Whitlake.
Exactly. Something I relate very much to the storm. Just hearing you, I guess, probably a few hours before the storm hit. But it's kind of funny that, you know, Danny's kicking up out in the Atlantic right now, almost 10 years to the date when Katrina.
Currently Category 3, but nothing to be concerned about. It's going to run into a wall of dry air and dump a little bit of good rain on Puerto Rico, and that'll be about it.
Yes. Well, that would be a great outcome for everybody. I had a question, Art. I wanted to know if you were going to have possibly Michio Kaku on in the future, one of my favorite guests you've ever had.
Oh, yes. Yes, we have a great lineup of guests coming, but, you know, I really can't talk about the guests coming because of reasons that I'm sure you understand.
Sure, and I was just curious. I've always been a real big fan of Neil deGrasse Tyson, and I know he's never been on your show, and I was wondering, is there a reason for that, or do you have plans to maybe
get him
on in the future?
I have plans, yes. But, you know, I can't tell you when, but yes, he's coming.
Well, sure. Great to have you back on, Art, and thanks for taking my call.
Right, thank you for making it. And again, if you have made a deal with the devil, then, and while I appreciate your well wishes and everything, this is only if you made a deal with the devil. Otherwise, do not call this number. I mean, who knows? Think of it this way. The devil might be out there right now. And if he is, and he knows you're trying to call that line, he might assume you're a candidate for a deal. Trying to put you off a little bit. So, if you made a deal with the devil, it's area code 575-208-7787. Special number, 575-208-7787, but only if you made a deal with the devil. That's all. All right, let's go to, I don't know, let's go up here and say hi, you're on the air.
Hey, Art. Good
hey.
To talk to you, buddy.
Hey.
So I want to confirm that while you're on hold, you're definitely not getting any audio from the show. So that's probably why you got to...
Man, I so don't get that. When I was in a break, I called one of the lines myself, and I was hearing the show. I don't get it.
Interesting.
Yeah, very interesting. How could it be on some lines and not other lines? I don't get that.
Well, it's a bug. I'm sure you guys will figure it out sooner or later.
Oh, it really is a bug. Hold on a minute. I'm putting you on hold. I'm going to count to four. One, two, three, four. Did you just hear me count to four?
No, sir, I did not.
Oh, man.
That's why we're all toggling back and forth to make sure we don't miss any of the show while we're on hold.
Got it.
So I had a couple of comments about a show you had earlier in the week. You had Joe Rogan on,
I
caught the tail end of that when he was talking about his sensory deprivation chamber or tank.
Right.
And then you had David Sirita on immediately after that. And one wonders if David has his own sensory deprivation tank, because some of that stuff he was spouting off about, I almost pulled the rest of my hair out. I can tell you are a bit frustrated too. I mean, I don't have much hair to pull out.
Yes, nor do I, sir. I followed David to a certain point, and some of it I understood, and then he went off a cliff and lost me, and I tried to get myself back, but I couldn't, and apparently you couldn't either. So, yeah, that's the way it goes sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, the simplest way to see that there were some flaws in the mathematics he was using when he was discussing the standing wave frequencies around the stars.
Yes.
And he defined it as the frequency of is the speed of light divided by the radius of the star, or basically the circumference of the star, but it boils down to the radius of the star.
Right.
You know, disregarding the factor of 2 pi. So in the tones that you played for him, the one for Vega, it was a nice, beautiful tone, but it was a high-pitched tone.
Right.
It was a high-pitched tone. Now, you also played a NASA-measured tone of our sun.
Yes.
And it was much, much lower, if you recall.
Yeah, oh, yes.
Now, yeah, so if my third-grade math doesn't fail me here on your radio show, wouldn't the star with a larger radius be lower?
One would think. But who am I to judge? Yes, I would think. And I thought, by the way, for what it's worth, I thought the sun was the best. I really liked it. I don't know, when I heard the sun, it sounded like something baking to me. And I mean baking. All right, now, once again, let us pick up the I Made a Deal with the Devil line. Hello? Hello there.
Hello.
Yes.
Hey, I made a deal with the devil.
You did?
Yes.
And how long ago? You sound young. How long ago did you do this deal?
Oh, this is very recently, Art. I'm only 23 years old.
22.
Yep.
Okay, I'm impressed, I think. What was it that you wanted out of this deal for yourself?
Well, the deal was that I'd give him my soul, but in exchange, he'd have to give his soul to God.
Well, that'd be a non-starter.
Want to know what he told me?
He probably told you to go to hell?
He told me to get the heaven out of hell.
Come on now. You didn't really make a deal, did you?
No, that's all.
You're another
Bring
faker.
Your back on the air.
Another, yeah, I'm glad you're glad. Thank you. I do appreciate it. But, you know, I want people that made deals. Hello there. Did you make a deal with the devil?
Hello, Art.
Hello.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Hi.
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 Do I have two people here?
No, just one.
I could have sworn I heard another voice. Okay. Anyway. Proceed.
I made a deal with the devil, but it's a little different than the other stories that I'm hearing on the radio.
Well, that's quite all right. Everybody has their individual deal, right?
Right. Mine was almost to the day 18 years ago.
Can you hold on during our break?
Yep.
You can? Okay. Good. It sounds like it's going to be a good one. Stay right there. I'm sorry if you can't hear us on hold. I don't know what to say about that. We're working on it.
Yeah.
Kingdom of Nye in the high desert. This is Midnight in the Desert with Art Bell. Please ring Art's bell at 1-952-225-5278. That's 1-952-CALL-ART.
Sorry about the apparent thing with not being able to hear while you're on the phone. You definitely should be able to hear. It's ridiculous. So we will get that solved. Let me try something. I wonder if I push this. No. Probably shouldn't have pushed that. Or this. Probably shouldn't have pushed that either. Well, we'll figure it out. Going back now to our caller. Hello there. You were telling us you had made a deal with the devil, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Anyway, 18 years ago, actually, on September 27th, it'll be 18 years. I was in the middle of childbirth, and it looked like neither of us were going to make it, and I'm not a religious person. I just remember as they were, all the medical teams were rallying around and doing everything they could. I just said, anyone, you can have whatever you want. You can have my soul. You can have any part of me. Just save this baby. And right about then, her heartbeat started picking up, and they were able to get to her. And as soon as they were able to get to her, she started crying.
Well,
and I will tell you that there's been a lot of uptake for the last 18 years, believe me. But she made it. I don't know. Was it the devil? Was it God? Everybody can have their own opinion. But since I didn't, I just said anyone. I believe it was. And I believe I have paid, and I believe I will continue to pay. But I hope that wasn't too boring of a story for you. But I think there's a lot of ways that we make
deals,
hacks.
Yeah.
With.
Yeah. Well, you know, in that case, I mean, it really, even though you didn't specifically make the deal with God in that situation, I'd sort of give you the benefit of the doubt. So you're probably all right. But you did specify anybody, huh?
Yeah, I didn't care. I'm sure you've not been in that situation exactly, but...
No, I certainly have not. Nor do I look forward to it.
Anyway,
I think you're all right.
That's
my pronouncement. I think you're probably okay.
Okay, well, I didn't even know who you were until like a week ago, so...
Really? How did you find
me? My boyfriend, I guess, has been listening to you forever.
I see.
And so now,
you're
every
infected.
Night, you since you came back on,
you're infected.
You're played until I fall asleep.
I see. All right. Well, listen.
Anyway, I hope I didn't bore your listeners too much.
No.
Thank you.
No. This way, you'll when you pass on, you'll be surprised.
Yeah, and. Not everything in life has to be about sex, just so your listeners know that.
Well, there was another caller who thought that it did.
Years.
Yeah, that's right.
I guess you heard that.
I did. Thank you very much for the call. Take care. Oh, my goodness. Let's go to Tim. Hello, Tim.
Oh, right. Hey, good God. I can't believe that that girl was talking about no sex. Okay, early 90s listener. So for the Midnight Gambler, I would like to ask you, would you take a request or would you rather hear a story?
Well, when you say request, what do you mean?
A request asking for somebody or something on your show or a story. Your choice, dealer's choice.
Whichever you feel is more important.
Oh, my gosh.
You're the caller.
You know what? I bet you get so many things anyway. Okay. Here's the story of 444.
Okay.
Two of my friends in... I live in Los Angeles.
Yes.
So two of my friends were in Los Angeles staying in a in a high-rise apartment building, stepped out to have a smoke on the balcony, and immediately noticed that there was a gigantic craft hovering over West Los Angeles, with the city shimmering under the reflection of the lower half of the craft. After this occurred, both of them noticed a very interesting thing, was that the number 444 always came up. And we can understand how you could make that happen in your mind, you know. But it was very interesting how this strange number 444 kept coming up with them, whether it was page numbers, things like that. And after they told me that story, now I know this one, where I think their original one's real. You know, it's a real situation. But here's the funny thing about the human mind.
Yes.
They told me that story, and then I think I put that into my own mind, because after that story, I started noticing 444. You know, I'm like driving by the hamburger place.
Yeah, but
like
this is, you know, this is just a psychological thing.
Yes,
if I talk to you about 1111, you're going to see it everywhere, you know.
Absolutely, but I still think it's kind of a funny story. And just before I go, I'd like to say that I really appreciate the hard work that you do.
Okay.
I know that it's hard work.
444, thank you. Take care. Yeah, that's such a line of, you know, that's just psychological garbage, I think. I'm sorry. I know they have people that talk on just about numbers, right? Numbers people. What absolute hogwash. Hogwash. Hello there. You are on our I Made a Deal with the Devil line.
Yes, sir. How are you?
I'm very well. You really made a deal with the horned one.
Yeah, pretty much similar to the other guy you had on that sex thing.
Yeah, I'm sure that the sex thing is very, very common. I know that
weird.
You know, when you're in your early 20s, for example, you know, the hormones are raging. Actually, way before that, I imagine a lot of 16-year-olds made that deal. So
yeah, it's weird that you have this topic tonight, because just yesterday I have subscribed to you like on YouTube,
yes,
on Arbel, and I was listening to all your conversations with Father Malachi, and you know, it was kind of like weird. I started thinking about this. I haven't thought about it in years, you know. And
so how old were you when you made the deal?
About 20, 21.
Okay. How has it gone since?
Well, actually, there was a lot of, I've had my share, that's for sure. But it's kind of like with a curse, you know, because there was all kinds of, you know, drugs and alcohol involved.
Oh, yes.
Mental health issues.
Oh, yes.
You know,
we got that from the other caller too. So, do you at this point, do you regret the deal, or do you look forward to a continued life of debauchery?
Well, I'm 60 now, so hopefully I just turned 60. So
I'm 70.
Well, yeah, but I'm not.
I still look forward.
Knocking it, but yeah. So do I. But it's just that I,
yes.
You know, well, I'm on Social Security now, so, you know, and,
you're on Social Security at 60?
Yeah, I get, I was unable to work. It took years. Well, because of, like I said, the, mental health issues. The depression.
Yes, okay. Well, so you're still, raging away with the women, eh?
Well, not really, but it is, well...
Well, in that case, then you have only to look forward to payment time.
Well, here's the thing. When I was listening to the, like I said, the thing with Father...
Malachi?
Malachi Martin.
Yes.
You know, I was a Catholic.
It doesn't matter. You made a deal with the devil.
Born again Christian. Yeah, I know. But
doesn't matter what you are. No,
right?
Irrevocable, sir. Irrevocable.
Right?
You hear me? Irrevocable.
I hope not.
Oh no, irrevocable. No. You can't. At 60 years old, go back and think about all those women you had, and I know you had many because I can hear it in your voice, and not know that you're going to have to carry through with your deal.
Well, going to do it.
Oh, you don't think so, huh? All right, fine. Well, thank you for the call, and good luck. Why would somebody call me with a name like Joe Stalin? Joe, hello. You're on the air on Skype. Is your name really Joe Stalin?
Is this me?
Are you Joe Stalin?
No.
Why does your Skype say Joe Stalin?
Well, he's got a good mustache.
Yeah.
This is such a pleasure to speak to you. It sounds like... Oh, my goodness. I've been listening
I'll
to
tell
you.
I tell, let me tell you how good the audio is. I can hear a dog barking way in the distance.
Yeah, and I... I keep telling that dog to be quiet. Mm-hmm. It keeps me up at night. No, well, it really doesn't.
You can Art, make a deal.
Art.
Yes.
I did make a deal with the devil.
You did?
I absolutely did.
Oh, God.
By the way, I'm Jared from Salt Lake City.
Maybe I should say, oh, goodness. When did you make the deal, Jared?
Well, I fell in love with a girl. I was 24.
Mm-hmm.
And she was 18.
Oh, yes.
And I spent 2 years with her, and I really screwed up.
Yeah. And you lost her?
Yeah, I did. I absolutely did.
And that's when you cut your deal?
Well, not initially. You know, was trying to weigh my options and things like that. I was praying, and it wasn't working out.
Got it.
So I, said, okay, I'll do this right. If I get her back.
Yeah, that's the deal. Did you get her back?
I did. I absolutely did.
And are you still with her to this very day?
No, sir. And this is where it gets technical.
Okay. Well, there's no technicality about it. You got her back. There was nothing apparently in the deal that you would keep her forever.
I don't mean to interrupt you, but there was technicality.
Like what?
Because I got her for 2 years after that. You know, 2 years.
Well, you didn't say forever.
I know, but let me tell you.
That's the way the devil works, see? You did get her. You got your wish.
I did.
And then you lost her 2 years later. Tough beans. You owe one soul.
But the problem is...
What?
Is that after that, I became an alcoholic.
Yeah, well, that figures.
And I have no ability... to sustain a relationship anymore. You know what I mean? It's not
I
like...
I do. I mean, look, this could be right out of the Twilight Zone. I mean, this is the way deals with that guy go down.
I know.
You said you wanted her. You got her. And, you know, that nobody said for how long. Nobody said how your life would be afterward.
I know, and that's why I think if people are making deals with the devil...
Yeah.
They need to make specifics.
Well, absolutely. I mean, it's all about contractual law.
I don't even know what that means. You're using
okay,
big
well,
words.
Yeah, I'm sorry. In other words, you need, the way you put it, you need to be specific.
Right.
All right.
And I wanted her,
oh, yeah,
I think,
I get that.
Until I...
Yeah, but you needed to say that.
I know, but that's why I'm on the air right now. I'm trying to tell everybody.
Don't do it.
No, do it. Just make specific statements.
Okay. So you're not saying don't do it. You're saying...
Art.
Yeah, I got it.
We're going on break, right, Art?
We are. Be specific.
I just want to say before we go, I love you with all my heart. I'm glad you're on the air, and this is... You're doing the best you've ever done.
Thank you, brother. Enjoy the deal.
Doing all right. A little driving on a Saturday night. Come up, man. Running down the day. You get hurt by the little things.
call screening. No waiting on hold. No requirement to kiss Art's ring. Just good talk. Join Art by calling 1-952-225-5278. That's 1-952-CALL-ART.
Well, I don't know what to say. The I've Made a Deal line has been full all night long. Absolutely all night long. So a lot of people have gone down this road, apparently. Very, very interesting. So let's see what to do. Well, back, I just can't resist. Back to the I Made a Deal line. Hello.
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 How's it going tonight?
It's going pretty well. You would not be on this line having not made a deal, right? So you made a deal with the devil of some sort?
I guess you could say of some sort, yeah.
I am saying that. So what sort was it?
And, yeah. I mean, so, and I'm not proud of it either.
I understand. So, I mean, tell us all. I mean, you might save somebody else's soul if you tell us.
So it kind of happened a while ago.
Okay.
And I was living with my father and my stepmother.
Yes.
And I really did not like my stepmother.
Stepmoms really take a bad rap, don't they?
That's what I always hear.
Yeah. So you didn't like her?
Don't want to generalize, but
it's fine.
I prayed and prayed even to God, you know, that just she would go away out of our family's lives.
Yes.
That went unanswered. I kind of lost faith.
Mm-hmm.
And I started praying.
I suppose you were saying things like, what kind of God wouldn't take her away, right?
And I didn't mean, like, kill her. I just meant, would our family be at peace?
Okay. And so, dare I ask, what happened to stepmom?
She's no longer with us.
So, again, we have a case of somebody perhaps not being too specific.
Me?
You. In other words...
No, it was very specific when I prayed to the devil to take my stepmom's life.
You did pray to take her life?
Yes.
Oh, my. And how long was it after you did your prayer that she expired?
Maybe 3 or 4 months.
Pretty fast.
It was very soon after.
Wow.
And it was a car accident, and I wasn't in an accident.
And I bet when it happened, you knew right away.
I did. Yeah, I was shocked. I was almost catatonic for a while.
Mm-hmm. So this was how long ago, roughly?
This is precisely 3 years ago.
3 years
happened,
ago.
Okay. Right before Christmas, actually.
So how are you feeling about all of it now?
Guilty.
Yeah. Well...
But also, at the same time, I'm relieved because...
Well, yeah, I get that.
I didn't like her.
Well, right. And, an apparent success, and I don't know, this is going to set up a model, I'm afraid, for other people.
Yeah. I don't want to.
Yeah.
You know?
Do you have any advice for anybody else who might be considering a deal like the one you did?
It goes back to, be careful what you wish for. Even though I got what I wanted, it kind of haunts me. And
kind
I feel
of.
Like I'm...
Kind
intended.
Of.
Well, I mean, this is hard for me to even talk about right now.
I understand. But I said kind of. I mean, of course it haunts you. It's probably something with you every day now. Any ideas, any thoughts on what it's going to be like? I mean, for you.
Going forward?
Well, going...
Afterlife?
Going down. Yeah.
I don't even want to think about that, really.
I wouldn't want to think about it either. I did a story, it was a number of years ago. This would be such a good life lesson for you if I could possibly find it. See, I can actually stand up and walk around in the studio. You're hearing me just fine now, right?
Yeah, I can hear you loud and clear.
Okay, cool. All right, let me see. Do I have time to do this? Yes, I do. So the Russians, many years ago, actually dug a hole deeper than mankind has ever gone before, and they dropped a microphone in. I've got a wire story to back this up that I can't read right now. It was in Siberia, actually, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
They dug a hole, and they lowered a microphone down into the hole, and here's what they heard. Gave you a little piece of it there. Sounds crowded, huh?
Yeah.
So, and I'm not saying that that's what it's going to be like, but, you know, it's at least a possibility. So you're okay. All right, well, listen, thank you very much for the call, and I really don't know what to say to you, except that you really are gone. Gone. That's not a break. Not just yet. Just wanted to get a crash in there for you. All right, let's go to Jason, I believe it is, on Skype. Hello, Jason.
Hello.
Hi.
Hey, I'm a big fan.
Oh, thank you.
I just wanted to know if you'd seen a movie called, it's a time travel movie called About Time.
Oh, why doesn't that sound familiar? The premise?
Basically, a family has the ability to time travel, and I guess like when the male turns 18, his dad tells him that he can go back in time.
Huh.
It's really good. It came out like maybe 3 years ago or so.
Right. I really don't think I've seen it, and I thought I've seen every time travel movie that was ever out there. Apparently not.
It's really good. It's not, you know, super sci-fi. It's more like it's a romantic movie, and tells a good story and everything too. So real good movie.
Right. Well,
so.
There was also another romantic one called Somewhere in Time. You know about that, right?
Yes.
Christopher Reeves, Jane Seymour. Man, what a movie.
Yeah, I haven't seen that in a long time.
There's something so utterly, incredibly romantic about the possibility of travel in time. I love it. I absolutely love it. Anyway, appreciate the call.
Also, a guest suggestion.
Yes.
I know he has his own show, but are you ever going to have Richard Hoagland on with you?
Oh, sure.
Okay.
Sure. The real problem, of course, is that I'm on for 3 hours, and then Richard follows with 2 hours after that. So if I had him on, he'd be on for a total of 5 hours.
Well, he could probably talk about 24 hours straight, so.
Richard can do that. It's true. Have you had an opportunity to sample his show yet?
Once or twice, so I'm on the East Coast, so that's like 3 a.m. I'm about done at that point, so.
Right. Well, that's why we have Richard has a $5 subscription, and he dispenses a very great deal of wisdom and science. It's really actually quite a good show. It's a different Richard Hoagland than you're used to. Let me put it that way.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, I'll check it back out.
Don't get me wrong, still the same Richard Hoagland, but different, because he's more relaxed, and it's just really a cool show. Check it out, all right?
I will, thank you.
All right, well, this time it is a break, so here we break. That line is just ringing and ringing and ringing. Oh, people.
They turn black, sky ripped apart, rain for years, lit down to my heart.
Goodbye.
clock strikes 12 and midnight in the desert is pounding packets your way on the Dark Matter Digital Network. To call the show, please direct your finger digits to dial 1-952-225-5278. That's 1-952-CALL-ART.
Somebody on the wormhole wants to know if I made a deal with the devil. It says, is it Rafe? Rafe, Art, it sounds like you've made a pact with the devil, have you? No, I have not. I certainly have not. Unlike many who have called tonight, I have not. Now, did I consider it at one time? Yep, and I rejected it. I think everybody probably... There's a comment about another talk show host. I won't do that one. I'm sorry about the hold, the no-show on hold thing, folks. We've got so much to do. So let me go overseas and say hi to Mark.
Yeah, hi, Art.
Who's been very patiently waiting. Where are you, Mark?
Yeah, hi, Art. This is Mark in Bern. Not only did I make a deal with the devil, I made a legally binding contractual agreement with the devil.
Oh, my God. Well, that's the wrong expression, too.
Yeah, I was married to her for 18 years.
You were... yeah, sneaky. So it was now an ex-wife.
An ex-wife, exactly.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't wish that upon anyone.
No, and actually the suffering that will go on for possibly the rest of your life will be just as deep and as bad as you might get otherwise.
Deep pockets, actually. If you want to talk about deep pockets, yes.
Oh, my. Well, how's Switzerland this morning?
It's good. I'm actually going to do a radio show in 20 minutes on community radio here in Bern.
Really?
Yeah. I'm a radio guy.
Put a plug in for me.
Okay. I will. And it's Radio Raba, Radio Bern, the first two letters from Radio Bern, non-commercial community radio.
Bern, baby, Bern.
Exactly. Thanks, Art.
Thank you very much, and take care. Bern, Switzerland. I can't be ignoring the rest of the world, and I tend to sort of do that. Sorry about that. If you're outside North America and you want to call us, it's so easy. Just go to your smartphone, put in Skype, and then make like you're going to add, you know, a contact, and add us, MITD55, outside the U.S. and Canada, MITD55, and then it'll be in your contact list. You can just hit it, and you can call us like Raymond has just done from somewhere or another. Hi, Raymond.
Hi there. Well, as I wanted to ask, what's your favorite subject?
My favorite subject? You know, I have so many, it's really hard to say, but this devil thing does get me going. Maybe there is something there. Where are you calling from?
I'm actually calling from Edinburgh.
Edinburgh?
Scotland.
Scotland?
Scotland.
Oh, I've my whole life, I've wanted to go to Scotland. I've been close by. I've never made it. Would I like Scotland?
It's a beautiful country, like.
It is.
Aye.
You haven't made a deal with the devil, have you?
No, I've not made any deals with the devil. I wouldn't do that.
I've talked to so many people today. Have you heard them? These people that made the deal?
Nah, I don't really know any people that have said to me, like, I want to make a deal with the devil, like.
Yes, well, many, many, many. I mean, this phone line hasn't stopped. I've only got one phone line for people who've made deals with the devil, and it's ringing off the hook.
Oh, that's crazy, like.
Yeah.
All these people that have made deals with the devil, again, because you don't know if you're got to, when you die, if you're got to lose your soul.
Well, yeah.
You know what I mean?
I know, but people seem to be willing to do it for things like, women, sex, money, you know, these...
And women, sex, money, women, and power.
That's right. Power, I forgot power, that's a big one.
Sure is, like...
Want to be king of Scotland?
Yeah, I'm from Scotland, yeah.
Well, you must have called for some reason that you have not yet enumerated.
That honestly, Deacon, what I phoned for, to be honest. I was just got a phone to ask you what your favourite subject was, but I sort of noticed time travel, Ken, a wee bit.
Time travel would be up pretty near the high end of the list, but I don't know, I'm still exploring subjects, and I think it's going to be a long time before I get done, so I honestly can't answer that. If you forced me into an answer, I would say time travel for now, but you know, we'll see.
No problem. It was good talking to you anyway, Art.
Good talking to you, too. Take care. That's some accent you've got there, Scotland. The cool thing is the worldwide reach that we've got here. It's just amazing. I mean, anywhere in the world can hear us. Now, in Scotland and places, Bern, Switzerland, for example, I think it's morning. So people are actually, if they sound a little groggy, you know, it's early morning. They're sitting there with their morning coffee or tea or something. Anyway, internationally, it's MITD55 into Skype, and then it's an absolutely free call. And here I think we have somebody who has made a deal with the devil. Hello?
Hello, Art.
Hi.
First of all, welcome back, or Roswell's to you, my friend.
Well, thank you.
Yes, I made a deal with the devil, and things just did not go good.
No?
Yes, I... my three biggest things I wanted was money,
money?
Power, fame, power. Women, actually four, and I got nothing. Actually, the only two things I got was a life supply of chugga and a Berkeley water filter.
Seriously? I mean,
yes,
you know...
I like the water filter.
Yeah, well, you're gonna need the water, buddy. You know, if you made a deal... I'm leaving you at this point. Oh, God, he's going to definitely need the water, especially for making that call and wasting my time. See, there it's constant. This I made a deal with the devil line is constant. The number is area code 575-208-7787. But I've got so much to do. Agent 007, or otherwise Cameron, I think. Hi.
Oh, hi there, Art. Oh, you kind of got a little bit of feedback.
Well, that's because you're not using a headset mic. You're just yapping into your computer.
I've got a headset mic.
Well, then it's not working.
Oh, well.
Okay, now let me help you. See, I might be able to help you, and then I can help everybody. So what you do is you go up to Tools. You see Tools?
Well, I tested this when I used the...
Actually, you know what? You're sounding a little better now.
There, fix the volume. That's usually what it is with this.
Okay. All right, good. Go ahead.
First time, or long time listener, first time caller. No, just kidding. Everybody hates that. I'm up in northern Idaho, and we're surrounded by fires.
Yes, I know. Believe me, even here in the desert, by the way, we are... our whole sky is full of smoke. I mean, it is awful. There is so much smoke from the fires here.
God. Well, have you ever heard of the 1910 blow up?
No.
Yeah, about 105 years ago today. It was actually on the 20th and 21st. There's a big cold front, which it's moving in again, and all these little spot fires started up all over the place, and all of a sudden this cold front blew in. Hurricane force winds kicked up, and the whole thing burned part of Montana, a lot of Idaho, Lolo Forest, Ponderé, and it just torched the whole landscape. Looked like something out of Fallout 3.
Yeah, it's bad. bad.
But, a couple of things. First things, if there's any firefighters, I was thinking about writing something. If you have any creepy stories about weird things you've seen in the fires, I've kind of wondered if you have any stories. And another thing, you're enamored with time travel, aren't you, Art?
I am, yes.
Are you into animated things so long as they're actually pretty entertaining and kind of serious? Not like Simpsons, but
yeah, I guess so. Why, you want to send me something?
Well, I was wondering if you've heard of a show called Steins Gate that kind of plays off of the John Titor thing.
I have not.
Yeah, it's based off of a visual novel, but if you have some time, I suggest that you look up the show, and it's Steins Gate, all run together, and between the two words, there's a semicolon. It's kind of an interesting thing.
All right.
And also, one more thing before I let you go and stop wasting your time, I want to say hello from X, Paranormal Ward. You ought to visit sometime. I host the thread every night for your show.
Oh, really? During the show? Okay. Well, thank you very much, and I certainly appreciate your call. Let's go... overseas. I've been ignoring them. I know. I'm sorry. Matthew, I think it is. Hello.
Hello.
Hi, Matthew.
I've been trying to call your, you know, devil line, but that seems to be completely filled up.
Wait a minute, Matthew. Where are you?
Where am I?
Yes.
I am from a small little town, Kingsbury, California.
Oh, Matthew. Matthew, you're on my international line, so I'm going to have to ask you to call. I'm sorry, Matthew. Really, I am. I have to enforce that. If I don't enforce it, everybody breaks that rule. So you're going to have to use the 51 line. 55, MITD55 is, you know, it's for people outside the country, right, in the rest of the world. And it's not easy for them to get through, especially through the rush of people calling from North America. So that's why we set it up. And if I don't enforce it, then they won't be able to get through. It's just that simple. But I appreciate the sentiment. I do. Mike, hello there. You're on the air.
Wait a minute, Matthew. Where am
I? Mike?
Yes, sir. How am I sounding?
Great, actually.
Oh, good. Okay. I've got an update on a story that I told you 2 years ago on Dark Matter about a house I was brought home to from the hospital when I was born.
Okay.
Let's see. Where should I start? Well, my parents lived in a house that was probably possessed by the devil. And there was a room upstairs that could be very hot in the winter, or in the summer, it could be very, very cold. And let's see. So they went and got some holy water from my very Catholic grandmother over in Illinois.
Right.
And my mom's mom, my maternal grandmother, went upstairs and sprinkled the holy water on the door.
And
it shook.
The door shook?
The door shook, she said.
Visibly, I mean, like...
I don't know. I was one. I don't remember a thing. This is a story I was told by my parents, and I'm pretty sure it's true, because they were freaked out and moved out the next day.
Mm-hmm.
Well, as an update to that, I'm now in a happy relationship with my girlfriend, and we have a baby, a three-year-old.
A three-year-old.
And she actually told me that she lived in that house.
And everything is fine.
Everything is fine now, but the weird thing is that when she lived there, because I asked her tonight, I go, when you lived in that house, did you see anything weird? She goes, yeah. She goes, we could see Jesus in the wall, in the paint. And everybody that come over could see Jesus in the paint, too.
Well, maybe somebody had a picture of Jesus up and tried to paint over it and didn't succeed.
I don't know. Maybe
either
the
that or it really was Jesus. Who knows?
It could be. Well, hey, thanks for taking my call, and Roswell's and Braps from Belgab.
Okay. Belgab, all right. Belgab is a site that follows this program to some degree or another, full of unusual people that I have described as vaguely lovable. Sometimes they're fun, sometimes they're mean. However... the one observation I would make about Belgab is, for the most part, it has more intelligent users than you will find on most boards. That's not to say they don't break out into, you know, like North and South Korea fights occasionally. Speaking of that, you're going to want to keep an eye on that tonight. It really looks like something is going to happen in the Koreas, or very well may happen. It'll be about 2:30 in the morning Pacific time, or just a few hours from now, so... that bears watching, because the idiot in the North has laid down a deadline, and he says either the South Koreans stop with the speakers or he's going to blow them to bits. All out war, he says. So you definitely are going to want to keep an eye on that. It's pretty scary stuff, frankly. We have, 35,000 Americans there? Serious stuff. Hello, Michael. You're on the air.
Sorry?
Yes, extinguish your instrument, please. By the way, while he's doing that, if anybody thinks they're going to call up and say a bad word on the air, it doesn't work. I've got a 7-second delay, so you're wasting your time. Okay, you all set? You got to turn it off. Mike?
Bart, I'm trying to call you, but I'm hearing the other broadcast.
Yes, Michael, that's because you've got to turn the other broadcast off.
Okay. One comment and a question.
Yes.
First comment, I'd like to ask everybody to become a time traveler because you've worked so hard to keep this thing going.
Thank you.
And second question, I've always wanted to ask you this for many, many years.
Yes.
When you were in the Union Plaza.
Yes.
You were broadcasting from there, and the...
He's having a hard time because he's got his radio still on, right?
No, my radio is off.
I can hear it.
Anyway, now I can hear you.
The Union Plaza,
at
yes.
At the Union Plaza.
Yes.
At that time, it was run by the Mafia, right?
Wrong. Well, let me put it this way. It was Jackie Gunn's Union Plaza. I have no idea if the Mafia was involved at any point. However, let me comment a little bit on the Mafia while we're on the subject. There are many native Las Vegans, including myself, who remember when a great, very great deal of Las Vegas was run by the Mafia. And frankly, it ran a lot better than it does now. And by that I mean there was less crime. It wasn't tolerated. The price of committing a crime, many times could end up being a lump in the desert. We have a lot of lumps in the desert. As you drive along, you'll see a lump here and a lump there. Sometimes those are people who, cheated in years past. So the Mafia was not in totality a bad thing in terms of Las Vegas. Now, since we have become law-like, since we have, what's the right word? Political correctness in the way the policing of Las Vegas is achieved. Well, it's not like the good old days. Or maybe I misjudged the good old days. I don't know. I made a deal with the devil line. You're on the air. Hello.
Yes, this is my first time to call you or hear you. Please tell me what's the correct number for people who did not make a deal with the devil.
Well, the very fact that you called this line is sort of an ominous thing. You know what I mean?
I've done things before that were immoral. Could I please have your regular phone number?
Yes, you may, but you're always going to have to worry about the fact that you did call this line. So subconsciously, you haven't made a deal, have you?
Well, by the time I got where there was a pen, I didn't hear the first number because the second number drowned it out.
All right.
I don't have a two-track mind. I tried to get to the pen.
Okay, I'm going to give you the number. You ready?
Yes, sir, please.
It's area code 952.
Yes.
225.
225.
5278.
5278.
Yes.
Would you like to let me say something on this line?
No. I'd like to. Don't believe me, I'd like to, but this is for people who made a deal with the devil. So if you want to cop to a deal with the devil, sure, go ahead.
Okay, I'll call on the other line.
I thought perhaps so. Okay, well. Sounded like a really nice lady, actually. We'll take a break here. From the high desert, this is Midnight in the Desert. I'm Art Bell.
When calling Midnight in the Desert, let the phone ring until answered. These calls are unscreened for your listening pleasure. Call 1-952-CALL-ART. That's 1-952-225-5278.
Boy, he just said a truth. When you call, just let it ring. We apparently have a little problem with our audio when I have you on hold, so just let it ring until it's answered. Better way to do it. All right, now, I've done something. Maybe. I'm going to have some of you help me out. I think I may have put myself up on Periscope. So I may or may not be on Periscope. Now, here's the deal. You've got to be attached to my my Twitter account. And I am ArtBell51. Let me repeat that on Twitter. I am ArtBell51. And if you are attached, then when I go up on Periscope, as I might be right now, hello, 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 I didn't even have a chance during the break to get it pointed correctly, so I don't know if anybody can see me. Somebody on Periscope or on who's on Periscope right now, please go to the wormhole and let me know if I am on or not. If not, I'll try and fix it in the next break. And if I am on, then welcome to watching the back of my head. It must be absolutely fascinating. Let's go to our I Made a Deal with the Devil line. Hello. Are you there?
Hello.
Hello.
Yes, I'm here.
Good, I think.
I started to make a deal with the devil, but when the great horned one and his minions appeared, as you call it, I chickened out.
Oh. Listen, if you called on the devil and the horned one actually showed up in person with his minions, it's too late. That's a deal done.
I don't know.
All right, what is it you wanted?
Well, I don't know if you want to hear what happened or the story.
I do. But when you're making a deal, usually it's because you want something, right?
It's hard to explain. I was just out of the military. This was in the mid-80s.
Okay.
And I worked in the semiconductors in Northern California, in the Bay Area.
Okay.
And this new woman at work showed up. She was very beautiful, very exotic looking.
Oh,
yes. The boss wanted me to train her.
Train her?
She started asking, on the equipment, on the computer.
Oh, well.
We worked in the semiconductors.
I understand, yes.
And she started grilling me about religions as a whole. And then she strangely said, have you ever, she said the old, if you relinquish your soul to the devil, you'd gain fame and riches. Or she said it really strangely. And she asked me if I'd be interested, and I was very nervous. I just kind of jokingly said, oh, it's something to think about.
Hmm.
Well, that night, yeah, all hell broke loose.
In what sense? I mean, were you with her that night?
No, sir, not at all.
Okay.
She just threw that one out there, and the shift ended.
Uh-huh.
And it was one of those nights where my parents were off on vacation. They asked me to house sit for them. So I was in my old home, in my old room, and somewhere between like 1 in the morning and 4 in the morning,
yes,
I heard this laughter, just this bizarre, just the weirdest laughter you'd ever hear.
Yes.
Basically just like that.
Yes.
And so I jumped out of my bed, opened my door, and I noticed every light on in the house. And even the oven light was on.
The oven light?
And I ran down. Yeah, I mean, every light was on. I mean, you name it. If there was a light involved, it was on.
The oven light, sir, and was just symbolic for you.
It could have been, exactly. And when I ran to the family room on those older TVs, when you shut them off, you know how the colors used to swirl and kind of fade out?
Oh, yeah, to a little dot.
Where the laughter... Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Well, that's where the laughter was coming from. And so when I ran in the family room, the TV was just turned off, and the laughter stopped. Well, I'm a chicken by trade, and I jump at my own shadow, but I wasn't scared at all.
No?
So I'm thinking someone knew I was there. Someone's playing a prank on me. I'm checking the doors. All the doors are locked. I'm looking under beds. I'm looking in closets. I'm looking, you name it.
Yes.
Yeah, my parents used to have little dowels in the windows that could only open the windows like a couple inches. I made sure all those were in place. Checked the garage. Every garage light was on.
Uh-huh.
This happened twice. The second time, even more laughter. There was like 7 people laughing.
Yes.
Really bizarre laughter. Well, the third time it happened, my dad's office door was slamming shut, opening up, slamming shut, and I opened my bedroom door just to see it swinging open.
Yes.
Every light was on again, and that's when I realized I was being ready to make the deal.
What makes you think you didn't make the deal? You don't get that kind of attention. You don't get that kind of visitor without a deal having gone down. Doesn't that worry you?
No, because nothing went down yet. This lady asked me, which, by the way, she never did show up at work anymore.
Yeah, but you did say. But you did say you repeated what she said.
She said, "Would I?" And I said, "It's something to think about."
Well,
And I think I was being tested.
Well, you were.
But
the question is whether you passed or failed.
Well, I told them to leave, and I didn't mean any bit of it, and nothing has ever happened ever since.
All right. Well, there's still time left in your life. Let me know how it comes out.
Will do, Art. I appreciate it.
All right, buddy. Take care. Let's go to, I think, Phoenix on the phone. Hi.
Hi, Art. I'm shutting off the line because of the hold. Thank you. It's Phil from Phoenix. It's great to hear you.
Thank you.
You're a visionary.
I'm not a visionary.
Yeah, you are, my friend. It's so interesting that people mention Union Plaza and also Parasite Radio, because I listened to you from the 90s, and I remember
Hold on. That's awful. It's not called Parasite Radio. It's called, and it's not radio. It's video. It's Periscope.
I know. I'm sorry. I'm nervous, Art.
I am,
and
too.
I caught by surprise because, you know, the delay on the DM.
I know. They could offended by that.
Yeah, I sincerely apologize, and Art didn't make the mistake I did. But I do like to see your first time in space on the days of 9600 baud on Videotron. Whoever knew that we would have that. But I really wanted to ask you the question. I knew before you got back on the radio that, on this show here, that you had some problems with the bumper music, how you were going to be able to... happened there?
Well, what happened there is we joined as what is called, we found something called a small webcaster model, which allows us at least, I mean, the music is very expensive, but... In my case, I just wouldn't do the show without the music. I just wouldn't do it. So we found a way to do it, and it's called the small webcaster model, and there you have it.
Cool. Well, I'm a time traveler now to help you support that, because all my days between Phoenix and California, when I moved out there and also listened to you from Union Plaza, AMDXing, it's been a pleasure. I'll leave with one last comment. The show that you had with Flat World John.
Oh, yes.
I'm surprised you didn't have Cracker Box Palace as a bumper song. But other than that, I'll leave the line for somebody else.
Right.
We're so glad to have you back. Thank you.
Thank you very much. You know, let me tell you something about that. While everybody thought that was crazy, and it was, the Flat Earth Show has received more comments. I don't want to say that anything else we've done, but it absolutely has received just endless comment. Not all of it positive, but that's the way radio is. A lot of times, what gets people to listen? Well, it's something they either love or it's something they hate. And a lot of people hated it. But you cannot underestimate the passion that these people who believe the earth is flat have. I mean, you simply cannot underestimate that passion. And these are otherwise bright people. So, I'm not sorry that I did that program. Not at all. And in fact, I might do another. You never know. I'm telling you, the passion is unreal. Anyway, let's go to my special I Made a Deal with the Devil line. Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Is this Art?
It is Art, and you are on the I Made a Deal with the Devil line.
That's awesome. You know what? I've noticed that there's an absolute lack in women calling tonight. Like, we don't make deals with the devil.
Well, mostly people make deals for you, my dear.
Well, you know, I don't think that that happened in my case, but my story is a little bit different. Like, I haven't necessarily made the deal, but I've definitely had the offer more than once.
What do you mean you had the offer? You mean somebody came and said, look, I can take care of that for you. All you need to do is XYZ?
Well, yeah, pretty much. That's kind of been it. I've had a series of dreams over the last 2 years or so.
Yes.
Where this entity has come to me in my dream and basically told me that I can have whatever I want. He'll give me whatever I want. I just have to be specific, and I just have to either give him my soul or the soul of someone I love.
Yeah, okay. Well, see, there was somebody here earlier who said, who had made a deal with the devil, and he said, one of the things you need to be sure of is that you are very specific about what you want.
Right, right. I heard that caller, and that's absolutely true. And it's something that I'm aware of. I've practiced witchcraft since I was 13 years old, so I'm definitely aware of the specifics.
Yes.
You know, and I'm definitely aware that I probably opened up some energies that I shouldn't have. But, you know, you had the priestess from the Church of Satan on earlier in the week.
Yes.
And she said something that really struck me that was kind of related, and it was that, you know, that kind of thing will drive you to the brink of madness. And I can definitely say in the last 2 years, despite the fact that I haven't really buckled down and said, okay, you can have my soul and, you know, we're going to do this, it's definitely changed me as a person.
Well, you're obviously teetering, right? Sounds like you're very close.
It doesn't make a lot of sense to me. It told me that it would take the soul of somebody that I loved, but to me that's kind of like, I don't know, like a Freudian slip. Like, if I loved that person, I wouldn't give their soul to the devil.
Well, at least you're not giving your own soul. I mean, I know it's selfish, but...
Well,
there's a lot of souls going here and there, and so... I mean, if you really want whatever this is, then as long as it's not me.
Right. I feel it. I would never do that, Art. I swear, I would never do that.
All right. Well, all right. Thank you very much for the call. But see, really, technically, I should have not let you get away with that. Yes, you were teetering on a decision, but you had not yet made one. James on Skype, you're on the air. Hello.
Hey, Belgab, Rod Roswell's there, Art.
Well, thank you.
Just wanted to tell you, I did cut a deal, not going into specifics.
Oh, this must be MV.
No.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No. I'm from inside Darby, Ohio.
Okay. So you actually did cut a deal.
Yeah. All right. Anyways, my thing was, I grew up in a trailer in the sticks. And I wanted to travel the world. I also wanted to achieve certain goals militarily and also in law enforcement. So I went into the Army at 17.
Yes.
Went into the Marine Corps at 20. Fought in the Gulf War. After the Gulf War in Okinawa, I found Jesus. Okay.
Was this before or after the deal?
After. After. I was a young
kid. It doesn't work. It doesn't work that way.
Well, it does, and I'll tell you why.
It doesn't. Once you cut a deal, it's irrevocable. It's
you say that, Art, but it's not.
I do.
And I'll tell you why I know.
Well, we'll find out at the end, right?
Well, I will. But what I'm telling you is my experience.
Yes.
My experience was, I still do what I do overseas. I'm still a contractor.
Yes.
And, you know, I've seen that I'm able to actually affect people in a positive manner.
Yes.
And also, you know, it's a total sea change from when I was 22 after the Gulf War.
Uh-huh.
And, you can tell when the worm has turned, as they say.
Yes, but you made a deal. That's the worm turning. Yeah, that's the worm turning.
I agree with that, but I'm saying that I did it as a minor who did not have full cognizance.
Oh, so you really think that the devil cares about how old were you at the time?
probably around 14.
14.
Yeah.
Well,
and there is something called, you know, even in law, somebody who's a minor and non-sentient, and trust me, I was an ignorant hillbilly. There's a big difference. And anyways, that's my story. It's truth.
And you're sticking to it, right?
Well, I'm sticking to it, and I'm telling you, I love your show, but I just wanted to give you a big Belgab Roswell and tell you that you're the man.
All right, buddy. You
God
take
bless,
care.
Brother.
Right, later. This is Midnight. I'm Art Bell. We're talking to people who have sold to the devil. Would that be you? Oh, no, let's go here. Let's go outside the country. Hello, it looks like Michelle.
Hey, Art.
Hey, Michelle.
Okay, I'm watching you on the Periscope on my iPhone and listening to you on my iPad.
How cool
is
that? That is awesome.
This is the coolest thing in the world. This is so cool, Art.
You're right. It is cool. It is. It's an amazing world we live in now.
Isn't it just? And I love your studio there. I remember pictures of your old studio, and it looked so huge, and you know everything everywhere, and so many machines and everything. And
yes.
This is just so seems so simple and easy to use.
It is. There are like parts of it that you can't see. I would have to point the camera around, but there are racks of equipment and stuff like that. So
I wondered. I got two things for you.
Sure.
First of all, where'd you get that that LED clock on the wall? That's cool.
Oh, let me give you a good shot of that. I love that clock.
That is the coolest clock. I'm just watching the video, and I can't stop looking at the clock.
There would be, coming pretty quick, a good, clear shot of it.
Oh, yeah, I see. Okay.
All right. I actually own three of those in totality. I love them so much.
That's cool. That is so cool. So I was going to say... story for you. When I was a kid,
you are in.
Don't mean to make you
Michelle,
feel.
You're in where? Where are you? Japan.
Oh, Japan.
Japan. Yes.
Near Fuji.
Right.
Actually, going to go climb it next weekend.
You're going to climb Fuji.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
So, when I was a kid, my dad used to go, and he'd have to make deliveries real late at night. He was a steel draftsman, and sometimes they'd ask for last-minute changes.
Right.
He'd have to go deliver them real late at night. So he'd put me in his truck, and off we'd go at, you know, 1, 2 in the morning. And I would sit there in the truck and wait while he was talking over the plans and everything. And he'd be listening to you. And, I mean, I'm maybe, you know, 11, 12, that kind of range, listening to you talking about aliens. And you used to scare the crap out of me.
Mm-hmm.
But I loved it. And
so,
now, you know, listening to you again and then going back and listening to those old shows.
Not much has changed.
No, you know, in a lot of ways, I don't think it has, really.
No. No, I still do the same thing.
And so that reminded me, too, guest I wanted to ask you about.
Sure.
Do you have any plans to have or know anything about David Politis?
Yes, he's coming.
He is.
You know,
coming.
I really don't, I don't want to give away about guests, but people ask me and I can't resist. So, yes, he's coming.
Sure.
He's coming.
Well, he's one of the ones that, of all the things that I've heard in all the years I've been listening.
Yes.
His scares the crap out of me.
Well, you know what? He may know where some of the people, you know, who are admitting to these deals tonight are.
No, that's a thought.
It's a thought. All right, Michelle.
But yeah, his really, just because it's the realism, the fact that it's so verifiable, it's really happening, and
yes.
He has no idea why it's happening is what makes it so scary.
Would you like to talk to somebody who's made a deal with the devil?
Sure.
Okay. Hello there. Have you made a deal with the devil?
I have. I was about 14 years old after my father had passed away. And, well, I grew up in kind of a party house and had some crazy role models and whatnot. And when I was younger, we went ahead and we started cutting ourselves, you know, and our left wrist and drawing the blood out onto a piece of paper.
Yes.
Now, what we had to do in order to sell our soul to the devil was to go ahead and sign our name in our blood, and signing it over to the devil, then burning it in our wood stove.
And you did that?
And of course.
Wait, where'd you hear that? Who told you that?
Yeah, that,
it was an old friend of ours we grew up with and partied with. And,
you're talking to Michelle. Know. You're talking to Michelle in Japan, just so you understand.
Oh, okay. Hello.
Hi.
Hi, Michelle.
So, Michelle, go ahead. Interview her. Let's find out about this.
Okay. Well, you know, I grew up, when I was a kid, I went to a Baptist school. And I'm very far from that now. But when I was a kid, even talking about that kind of stuff was a big no-no. I mean, it was drilled into our heads that we were going to go straight to hell, that something horrible was going to happen. So what did you think? I mean, did you think anything was going to happen? Did you have that in your mind at all?
At the time, I thought it was possible. It was right after my dad passed away and my mom moved out of the house. And so it was just me and my brother raising ourselves, and we were teenagers.
Nothing to live for in a way, I guess.
And, basically, yeah. And actually, 2 years later, my mother ended up overdosing on medication and passing away as well.
All right. Well, you know, you don't make a deal for nothing. So, I mean, what did you want in return for this?
Well, I wanted my dad back. Well, that didn't exactly happen.
There's a show that's really popular in Japan about a bunch of alchemists, a couple kids that are alchemists that try to bring their mom back to life using alchemy, and which is the one thing you're absolutely prohibited from doing is trying to bring someone back to life. And it ends up, you know, ruining their life and putting them on a journey to try and fix everything. His brother gets turned into a suit of armor because his soul gets disconnected from his body, and they really messed up their lives trying to do that. And so it just kind of reminded me of that. But that's scary stuff. That's the one thing. Oof, trying to bring someone back from the dead, man.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't know exactly what I was doing. I just knew that I was willing to do what I could, and we also grew, like I said, party house, so drinking was involved as well, and other people were on drugs, so it was a little bit of a crazy thing. But we had some crazy circumstances arise after that. We had some Ouija boards brought into my home as well.
Ooh,
and we moved our hands. That thing moved.
Oh my.
I don't know how.
I'm with Art on that
like
one. No Ouija boards.
It's cardboard.
Nope.
Okay, so.
But it was moving. Fully, it was pretty insane.
All right. Well, it sounds insane. Michelle, thank you, and thanks for helping with the interview. And so my question to you is, how do you feel now about the fact that, well, your fate is sealed in blood at that?
Well, I just live life. It doesn't, I don't look at all the negative things that happen and think that that's the reason, you know, Art. But I do, you know, it does go through my mind here and there of, you know, am I cursed? I ended up dating a coworker of mine, and, his son's name was, Damien, and his name was, Byron. And, the thing about it was, I didn't know that he was considered a Satanist. He told me he did not believe in, Satan and all this, but I went over to his house and he had, all sorts of Satanist books and a few other weird.
All right, listen, I've got a break. I've got a break. I've got a break here.
Okay, well,
hold
thank
on.
You so much, Art.
You're very welcome. Want to call us at the following number, 575-208-7787. That's the number. You never know. Admitting what you've done, confessing as it were, might help. I doubt it, but it might. Area code 575-208-7787. And my, it's been a busy line. MJP, it's your turn. Hello.
Hello, Art.
Hi.
It's been a while since we've talked on the phone, back from the Ham Fans days and all the rest of that nutty stuff.
Yep, long time ago.
Actually, I'm wondering, for Halloween, you should do a whole week of open lines, different topics, all night.
Well, I'm thinking it over. What Halloween is going to be on the air, it's going to be something special, that's for darn sure.
Oh, yes, definitely. I don't know. I keep listening to these people saying they've made a deal with the devil, but yes. You know what? If they've made a deal, they better get a receipt so they can get their money back when things don't work out.
Well, you know, so far, of those that have called, not much has worked out. I mean, the people have received what they asked for, and usually then things kind of go sideways.
Well, you never get what you ask for when you're trying to sell your soul, because that's the way it works. Nothing will ever go the way you plan. The devil is in the details. You know?
So they've said, yes. In other words, when you make your deal, at least get the details down. In other words, if you ask for a girl, I mean, you'll get her. That doesn't mean two years later you're still going to have her. So.
Well, exactly. Yeah. This is the thing, is people don't really understand all this stuff, you know. When it comes to the devil, demonics, a Ouija board, playing with that stuff by yourself, I kid you not, that's not a cool thing to do. You know, people, you know, really just don't understand what they're getting into, because the mind is a very powerful thing.
It is indeed. All right. Well, thank you for the call. We're short on time. On my I sold my soul to the devil line, you're on. Hello?
Oh, great.
Great.
Hi, how are you?
So many of you that have sold your soul to the devil sound so cheerful.
Well, you know, I would be more cheerful, Art, you know, if I actually had been able to successfully sell my soul to the devil. You know, I have tried and tried and tried, but nothing works. And, you know, honestly,
No, sir. If you have tried to sell your soul to the devil, you're just buying it, you're selling again and again, because it gets sold first time around.
I see. I don't know if that's really how it works, because I have not gained anything other than just like a bigger desire to sell more of my soul to
the devil. What have you asked for? Surely you didn't dispense with your soul without, you know, something in return.
Oh, you know, sometimes it's a bigger thing than others. You know, it could be like a new car or you know, success in school, or, you know, as it so often is with a girl. Not that yeah. ever works out. But, you know, and no matter what it is, and this is kind of because I'm an unfortunate person in general.
And I hope you went for like a nice U.S. SUV or something. You didn't do it for a small car, compact, right?
Oh, no. I'm not really a hybrid guy. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm like 6'4", so I'm too tall to fit into anything but an SUV, really. But,
there you go.
See, I believe not necessarily.
Can I ask you a question? You know, do you have a SUV?
Yes, I do.
Uh-huh. There you go.
Well.
Nothing more to say.
Okay, then I guess I won. Although. Thank you, Art, for pointing out how I'm now going to hell. Although,
you're very welcome.
Something I really want to say
yes.
is that the way that I understand Christian theology, it kind of sounds like when you go to heaven, you it like kills your personality and your emotions and whatever. And so, to me, it reminds me a lot of a quote from Paradise Lost, where, and this is a loose paraphrase, it's like, it's better to reign in hell than to serve in heaven, you mm-hmm. know, where you can at least still feel pain instead of just being numb to everything and being kind of like a mindless slave in heaven. I don't know, that probably sounds kind of weird, and your viewers are going to
No. I can tell you're happy with your deal, and I'm happy for you, and I hope it's a nice SUV, you know, and I hope the passenger seat is filled up with somebody really cool. I guess it is. Hello there, Brenda, I believe it is, somewhere in the world.
Hello.
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 Can you hear me?
I hear you.
Okay. I can't, okay.
Where are you?
I'm talking from New Zealand.
New Zealand, okay. What you want to do is get good and close to the microphone on your computer.
I've got the headset.
Oh, the headset. All right. You see, I see I see a picture of Brenda, and I think I hear Brenda in the background, right?
Correct.
Yes, okay. Well, I'm glad to have you. What's up?
This whole changing from nice to not nice, a artist called Jackie Ivanko, who's 15, released a video on YouTube yesterday.
Yes.
And up until this time, she's been thought of as a angel from another planet and so on because of her beautiful singing. She was discovered on AGT in America in the fifth season. So she was 10 when she was discovered, and she's 15 now. And then her brother made the change, like Caitlyn Jenner made the change.
Oh, yes.
And the video is, the song is lovely in by itself, but the video conveys her story, so to speak, of the change.
So you're kind of advertising it now.
No, I'm not advertising. What I'm trying to say is that since the video was released yesterday,
yes,
on YouTube,
yes,
even long time fans,
yes,
have, because of the transgendered nature of the video, not the song, but the video.
Yes.
If you understand.
I'm with you.
Then, yeah. And so longtime fans have come out on YouTube and saying that she's the devil incarnate, that you're, you know, and so on and so on. She's uh-huh. a Catholic.
Uh-huh. Even Catholics can make bad deals.
Yeah, but she's... Oh, it's just a beautiful video, but at the same time, all of a sudden, fans from all over the world who thought she was an angel and so on, she's now, because of this video, she's being pariahed mm-hmm. well, because of the
change.
The content of the video.
Yes, I get it. All right, thank you very much. All the way from New Zealand. Do you know, I think, what is the furthest away that you can really go on Earth? Is it New Zealand? It's pretty close. New Zealand or perhaps someplace in South Africa from here on the West Coast. And really, you can't, if you go any further than roughly that, I think you begin to come back. So that kind of gives you an idea of the reach of the show. Scott, hello, Scott.
Hi, Art. How's it going?
It's going.
I sent you an email a moment earlier, about an hour ago.
By the way, anybody who wants to send me an email, it's artbell@artbell.com. Easy enough.
Okay. And I wasn't sure whether to call on the I Made a Deal line, because there was a deal, but it didn't involve my soul.
Whose soul?
Well, in 2006, I had occasion to buy a chunk of Pope Benedict the 16th's soul.
How do you get that opportunity?
Well, it was $15, and at the email I sent, you can see the numbered certificate. And the guy that was behind this was a Luciferian by the name of Aaron C. Donahue.
Well, how do you know you really had the goods to sell?
Well, I don't know. But it sounded like a unique item, one of 666 certificates.
Wouldn't you think... How many? 666?
Yes, you can see the picture. It's in the email.
Yeah, wouldn't you think that buying, a portion or 666, that's hard to say, of a Pope soul would be, you know, perhaps a scam?
Well, I guess it depends on where you're sitting. I mean, I have questions about the existence of, well, I know the Pope exists, former Pope,
mm-hmm.
but I'm not so sure about the good guy up in the sky or the bad guy way down below. So it was more of a humorous thing, and like I said, how many chances do you get to
not
buy
many.
A certificate?
Not many.
Good for one 666th.
You have to think, I mean, what if it's real? I mean, that's really horrible. Now you own part of a Pope.
I dug it up. I'm holding it right now in my hot little hands. I hope to get it framed.
I bet your hands are hot.
Yeah. But I wonder if someone would give me a hassle over framing it, because it is a rather contentious chunk of memorabilia.
I'm not sure what kind of frame you'd put that in.
Something with flames, maybe, or an effect of fire and brimstone. I don't know.
I mean, even having... purchased, and I presume you paid the money, right? $16?
Yeah.
Did this come from, I don't know, like Nigeria?
No, it was, I think it was in California somewhere.
Well,
yeah, Santa Clara.
Figures.
And I sent a message to Aaron. I kind of fell out of touch with him a while back, letting him know of your new program.
Oh.
But I don't know if he's doing media nowadays.
I see. Well, thank you. And you know what? It would sure be fun if you could take a picture of that certificate and email it to me. Could you do that?
Yeah, I'll scan it, and I'll email it at the same address. Actually, I don't really have much use for it. I'll give it to you for $5.
No. I just want to see a picture of it. That'll be fine.
Okay.
You hold on to the certificate, and lots of rock.
All right.
See you later. Ay, ay, ay. Part of a Pope's soul. Hello there.
Hello?
Yes, hello.
Hi, I'm sorry. Let me take you off speaker.
Yes, thank you.
Sorry about that.
Hi.
I had a question for you. I haven't sold my soul to the devil. I was curious.
Do you want to make a deal? Do you want to make a deal now?
No, I have no interest in making a deal. I think I have had plenty of sex just being a Catholic.
A Catholic entitles you to a lot of sex?
Well, I don't know. That's from what I've heard of the other callers selling their souls.
Actually, there are stories about Catholic girls. You know that, of course.
This is true. But the reason for my call is I wanted to know, down the street from you is the Amargosa Opera House. Have you spent any time there?
You mean, isn't a lot of time? No, I've been there and by it many times. And I know the story of, you know, it was purchased for that woman.
Yeah.
It's an amazing romantic story.
It is, but it's really haunted, too.
I have heard that, yes.
I was just curious if you had ever been there, because it's right down the street. I stayed there a couple of times.
And?
And I couldn't get a good night's sleep there. I won't stay there anymore, because all night long I had something waking me up.
Like what?
There. I don't know what it was. It was patting my bed all night, and I would try to ignore it, and then it would shake the bed harder.
It was patting your bed? I mean, like petting?
Like patting the bottom of my bed, like trying to wake me up.
Good heavens.
And then it was kind of like gently pushing my face.
Oh, my God. You know, I really have to ask, I mean, how does anybody sleep in a bed that something is padding, and then their face is touched, and then you're going to try to tell me you went back to sleep?
No, well, yeah, I tried. Well, I thought, you know, it's funny, I was half asleep. My girlfriend, or a friend of mine, was in that we had two double beds, and she was in there, and she had some strange experiences that night as well, and I was, in being half asleep, I was just thinking, well, maybe if I ignored it, it'll go away.
Mm-hmm.
And it didn't. It bothered both of us all night.
Just sounds like a place I'd like to stay. Gee.
Yeah, well, you know, it's funny because I know it's right down the street from you, and I thought you should go check that place out or at least investigate it a little more because there's all kinds of crazy stuff happening.
Yeah, well, Area 51 is just down the street, too, and the consequences are probably about the same.
No, the government won't shoot you or whatever the threats are.
Oh, yes, they will.
No, not in Amargosa, I mean.
Oh, no, not there. But Area 51,
yeah.
Guaranteed.
Yes.
All right, thank you. Thank you very much. That's I'm well aware of the Opera House. Hello there, wherever you are. You're on the air, I hope.
Thank you, Art.
You're very welcome.
A lot of people want to sell books, and I've heard several people on the air wanting to sell a book and telling people that if we have a massive blackout due to electromagnetic pulse, that it's physically impossible to pump gasoline with no electricity. And I've known all my life there's such a thing as a hand pump.
There's not so many hand pumps left anymore. If we had a massive EMP go off.
Catalog here. I mean, I'm looking straight at a catalog. Two pages full of them. These are sold every day and used every day. These are hand cranks. There's no excuse.
Well, you know, if an EMP goes off, it's the end.
Not if people will do right. you need to have this. If you've got a gas station, you should have this hand pump. And
are you selling pumps?
No, sir. Of course not. I would have too much competition because they're sold by huge companies like the Gempler Catalog in Northern Tool. I couldn't compete with them.
Well, you could try.
They're sold every day.
You have a lot of passion going for you. You could sell hand pumps.
Anybody can Google hand pump.
Well,
how can they get away with going on coast to coast and saying that to millions of people and having people swallow it whole, and they were on Ground Zero with the same story.
Yeah.
And I went on there and I told them, I said, I've worked at a gas station. I know there's a hand pump. And they made that out to sound like I was talking about another electric pump.
I see.
For backup.
Well, I let you say it, that's for sure. But
thank
you know what?
You for letting me say it.
You're very welcome.
You'd have to be an idiot not to know how to adapt one of these for pumping gasoline from a gas station.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you very much for your call and for calling Midnight in the Desert.
Thanks.
Yep, you're very welcome. Well, that was quite a night, wasn't it? It just astounds me. I mean, the I Sold My Soul to the Devil line just rang all night long. Just all night long. It just never let up. It's time for my weekend to begin. Not making any deals, but, you know, I've been here 5 days, so now I get the weekend. In all the time zones around the world, thank you all very much, and all of you have a good weekend. And I'll see you Monday. Night-night.